Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will show you some important pediatric fundal images and the spot diagnosis. This is a retinal fundus image as seen by the fundoscopy. It is a normal fundus. You can see that optic disc is present on the right side, so this is the fundus image of the right eye. Optic disc is present on the nasal side and it represents the beginning of the optic nerve. Macula is temporal to it and the central depressed area is the fovea. And fovea is the most sensitive part of the retina as it contains cones. You can see the retinal vessels and ora serota is the surrounding rim of the fundus. It is a fundus image of retinopathy of prematurity in which there is cessation of normal vasogenesis. It is characterized by a white demarcation line between vascularized and non-vascularized retina. There is fibrovascular proliferation adjacent to this demarcation line, and in severe cases, there are engorged and tortuous blood vessels. This is the fundus image of persistent posterior fetal circulation. You can appreciate the dense white membrane from optic disc to the ora serrata, and also there is retinal detachment. In this patient present with leukochoria, strabismus or nystagmus, and treatment is not possible. This is congenital rubella syndrome, which is also known as salt and pepper retinopathy. It is confined predominantly to the posterior pole in both eyes. In fundus image, you can see the diffuse retinal pigmented epithelial disruption and mixed hypo and hyperpigmentation. These are the fundus image of congenital toxoplasmosis chorioretinitis. This usually results in retinal scars. Strabismus, microphthalmia, cataract, optic atrophy, and nystagmus are also associated with congenital toxoplasmosis. This is fundus image showing a retinal astrocytic hematoma in case of tuberous sclerosis. This is solar retinopathy. It is due to unprotected solar eclipse viewing or sun gazing. You can see the yellow-white spot in the center of the fovea and the surrounding gray granular pigmentation. This is Coats disease. It is an exudative retinopathy of unknown cause. Usually boys are affected. There is telangiectasia of the retinal vessels with leakage of plasma to form exudates, retinal hemorrhages and detachment. This is cherry red spot in a patient with GM1 gangliosidosis. There is central red fovea which is surrounded by white ring of spongolipid laden ganglion cells. This is cherry red spot in Tay-Sachs disease. You can see the orange red fovea which is surrounded by a white retina. This is stage 4 papal edema. There is elevation of the entire optic nerve head and total obscuration of a segment of major blood vessel. This is stage 5 papal edema. There is severe papal edema, obliteration of the optic cup and obscuration of all the blood vessels on the optic disc. This is shaken baby syndrome or abusive head trauma. There are numerous retinal hemorrhages in multiple layers extending to the periphery. This is cytomegalovirus retinitis in immunosuppressed child. There are cotton wool spots that is soft exudate, retinal hemorrhages, retinal infarcts and retinal vasculitis. This is non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. It is characterized by microaneurysm, dot and blot hemorrhages, flame-shaped hemorrhages, retinal edema, hard exudate, cotton wool spots, and venous loop or beading. This is proliferative diabetic retinopathy. On the left side, you can see neovascularization of the optic disc. And in the right image, there is pre-retinal hemorrhages and vitreous hemorrhage. There are also fibrovascular bands and retinal detachment in proliferative diabetic retinopathy. This is retinoblastoma, which is a solid yellow-white mass adjacent to the macula. You can also see the dilated blood vessels. This is a characteristic fundus image of severe systemic hypertension. There is mild optic disc swelling, macular star, arteriovenous nipping, cotton wool spots, which are soft exudates, and flame-shaped hemorrhages. This is Roth spot in subacute bacterial endocarditis. There is a central yellow-white dot which is surrounded by a red area. These are retinal and macular hemorrhages which occurred in a patient with acute myeloid leukemia. He presented with visual loss and these hemorrhages were due to thrombocytopenia. This is optic disc coloboma. It is an abnormal hole which is present in retina from birth. There is focal glistening white bowl-shaped excavation and the normal optic disc structure is present in a wedge-shaped area in the superior zone. It is usually present in charge association, trisomy 13 and trisomy 18. This is optic disc Duchenne, which is typically present in Alagille syndrome. There are waxy pearl-like irregularities at the surface of optic disc. It is due to accumulation of hyaline-like calcified material within the substance of optic nerve head. This is retinitis pigmentosa. It may be found in isolation or in association with systemic or neurodegenerative disease. It is characterized by mid-peripheral bone spicule pigmentary retinopathy, vascular attenuation, and optic nerve waxy pallor. This is septo-optic dysplasia sequence in a 4-year-old boy who presented with reduced vision, pendular nystagmus, and short stature. The fundus shows hypoplastic optic nerve head and aberrant vascular arrangement. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel.